What is going on, guys? It's Reflex here, and we are at probably going to be the last episode, the finale, the ending, and I gotta say, it's been a long-ass journey, and it's finally gonna come to an end in this episode. It's gonna be a long one, too. It's not gonna be no short one, because I'm playing from here all the way until it's over, and I don't know how long that will be, but we got quite a bit. Keep in mind, this is right after the Prompto DLC.
It's coming from within. Is there no way through?
And it's that good, you know, good timing too, because we're about to find out who Prompto really is. Well, at least the gang is.
We already know because we played it.
So MTs, they've got those code prints, just like I do.
Do they? Never looked.
Yeah. So as it turns out, I'm one of them. Not exactly something I could tell people growing up in Lucis. Still, you guys are like the only friends I've ever known. I just hope that things can stay the way they were.
Whatever. Who cares where you were born? I don't see you turning against us. Not now or ever.
Thanks, guys. Still, I can't change where I came from. What I am.
Since when does where you come from matter to you? You never once treated me as a prince.
You know, not only does this, you know, show their true friendship, but it also kind of speaks to the world, to be quite honest. Because the world, as you guys know, the world's in an interesting place right now, where people, you know, dislike people because of where they come from. And, you know, this kind of speaks to that a little bit, because it shouldn't matter where you're from. You should be treated just as a normal citizen, you know? Well, that's kind of how I see it in this. And I think, if you think of it that way, it's kind of a cool, thing to think about. But, you know, it shows how close they are, too, because, you know, maybe a different group, they might have not have accepted him, but them, they accepted him for who he was, and that's awesome.
Should be up and running.
Alright, so that means we're about to get our weapons back?
Right. Well, Noctis? Come on, give me that. Sure. Oh yeah. Look how looks sexy ass.
Oh, we're back, baby.
Good game. What's that?
Let's roll.
Alright. Got my powers restored. With that being said, let's go ahead and actually put our weapons back. Alright. Always gotta equip the Ragnarok just cause this feels like the right thing to do. Not entirely sure what I want.
Whoa,
oh yeah, that's good. I wanted to. I really like swung it right in front of him. Well, that's a big ass great sword, honestly. It's kind of first Noctis fight in a while, because session wise it's been about, I'd say, 5, maybe 6, 7 days since we've played like Noctis' storyline, so it's been quite a bit. And this is just sitting there and not even getting attacked. Like, Ignis, you badass. My boy. For some reason I can't, they must have changed how the ring works. I'm trying to show off the ring, but I guess I can't do it the way I used to. I gotta remember how. Like I said, it's been a very long time. Certainly since I've used the ring. I haven't used the ring since my last playthrough, so it's been quite a while. Alright, let's go, Gladio. Be that, huh? Why am I still here and like fighting? Oh, there we go. I was like, I don't see anyone. We got Spider Lady, about to get her amp beat. Quick work with all these people. You know, I'm actually kind of excited to end it here, because it will be the first, I would say, Let's Play that I actually will complete that was a long Let's Play. Not like a Let's Play where I'm just simply playing the game, not even talking. This is an actual, I don't even know how many episodes it will be when this goes up, but it will be a pretty decently long one. And they were long Let's Plays, you know, that's the cool thing about it is that I took people's advice and basically created what people wanted back in the past. You know, they complained that Let's Plays were too short back then, so I made them longer. They complained that I wasn't talking during them. I decided to, you know, talk. So not only are they longer and I'm talking, but I think they're good quality, honestly. I think I've gotten better in a lot of, you know, aspects of making Let's Plays. And I'm kind of confused on where to go, to be quite honest. But I guess it's not a bad thing, because I got all these items, even though I don't ever use these.
Hey, buddy. Could you try to stick together?
Listen here, bud. I'm just kidding. Alright. I kind of, like I said, since it's been a while since the last session, I kind of forgot where to go. Alright. Just switching some things around to make it a little better for me. Here we go. Yes. I'm trying to show off this ring, but I really don't... Oh, wait, am I doing it? Okay, hold on. I'm about to show it off. Alright, you guys ready? Oh yeah, it looks so badass. It looks so badass. So, that is the Ring of Lucii in action. That is the Ring of Lucii in action. What it does is... Well, I'll read the name next time I do it, but I think you have to have full MP to do it. Because I just now realized I'm in stasis, so that means basically use it all up. But I guess, I don't even know if that's how it was back then. Maybe I just used a lot of elixirs, I don't remember. But once I get full MP, I'll test it out again, I'll tell you guys what it's called. But yeah, pretty much, it creates a different dimension and sucks them in. At least I'm assuming that's what it does. Which, hey, that's the best way to beat people, in my opinion. Is you sick of them, send them to a different dimension. This man is really stuck. I can't lock onto him because he's stuck. Oh, there we go. He probably wished he was still in there.
So, where'd you guys park the Regalia?
Outside. No park ain't the right word.
She's broken down, alas. Took one for us. Saved our lives.
Alright. A lot of enemies. We're in the home stretch. Got a little bit while to wait. Oh, what the hell was that? Oh, I didn't know that was a thing. But I'm wondering how to do the one where that I just did at the beginning. Maybe that was a lucky one. So I guess if you dodge, let me touch it. Okay, so if you dodge, you basically... Oh, but that drains MP if you hold it. Okay. Oh, but you get MP back, so you got time to kind of perfectly. I like that. But I guess if you dodge, the ring pretty much hurts the enemy. Which, that's awesome. I did not even know that. But that first dodge was badass. Like, I dodged them, and next thing I know, it, like, destroyed almost everyone. It's like I got Ultra Instinct, if you want to think of it that way. Like, I dodged real quick, and not from the naked eye, you couldn't see. But basically, I did, like, a time skip and hit everyone, and you couldn't notice.
Train drivers
and soldiers, they can fend for themselves.
Yes, they can. Yes, they can. Wait, look, it's the man. He's back. Oh, I got full. Altina, that's what this is called. Okay, so basically the ring has this basically ability, Altina, and I just destroyed everything. Now, they all just spawned, so that is not my fault. That, you know, the ring killed everything, but I didn't know there was going to be two waves of enemies. But yeah, that is one good thing about this ring. It comes in handy when in the Menace Dungeon a lot. Because if there's tons of enemies that you know is going to be hard to beat. And I didn't know this back in the day. I forgot all about the ring. But basically you can just use that to kind of cheese your way through it. And the bad thing is I didn't know about that. So I basically had to do it. I guess, not want to say the legit way because the other way is legit. But I had to do it the harder way. Which is doing it with only the weapons that I got.
Took more photos today.
Any good photos?
You want to see?
No. Not really.
That looked kind of cool.
Of course.
But I can't really tell. Oh, shit. That man really took a picture of me using the ring. You know what? We're saving that. That was pretty nice. I'm not even gonna lie. That was pretty nice. But yeah, as I was saying, I had to basically beat the Menace Dungeons. Not saying the right way, but I had to do it the harder way. And the last Menace Dungeon was even more difficult. Because the last Menace Dungeon, you have to basically not use any items. You're not allowed. So, that was a pretty difficult task. But it was doable. It wasn't impossible. It was doable.
Look at all this space.
So, the central elevator's through here.
And out of the loading bay.
Alright. Oh, I was about to say, like,
Your
is that
Majesty,
where I go?
Your precious crystal awaits you. To liven things up, I thought I'd take you on a stroll down memory lane. Of course, memories decay with time.
Oh, yeah, I forgot all about this. Man, that sucks. You know, it really sucks. The way Ravis went out kind of sucks. I mean, it's kind of... Well, I guess at least he's telling Noctis to kill him, but, like, it sucks because... He finally came around to Noctis, basically, well, finally came around to accepting Noctis as king, and then the last image in his head is basically Noctis pretty much swinging a sword at him and killing him, and that sucks because I don't know if, you know, he was still slightly alive after that or not, but if not, then he really probably thought Noctis was the one that pretty much murdered him, which... Very indeed sucks. Oh yeah, aw. Oh, they made me dodge instead of block here. I guess I didn't do it in time. There we go. Yeah, this is kind of a good fight. I'm sorry, Ravis. Gotta end it. I should have missed. Oh, this is awkward. Okay, this is kind of... Oh, and I'm in stasis, but luckily they got me warp points. All right. You know, you haven't been seeing that pretty much the whole entire game. This is probably the most technical fight throughout the whole entire game in my playthrough. For the reason, you know, being level 99 throughout the whole entire game, you don't really have to do any of these point warps or anything because you don't run out, but... You know, this is kind of cool. End-game content, you pretty much have to actually fight, which I like a lot. Alright, come on, Gladi. Use Gilgamesh's sword. Or was it Korra's sword? You know, actually, I think it's Korra's sword. Leave down in the comment section if you actually know which sword it is. I think it's Korra's. If I'm not mistaken. Whoa, that was pretty badass. I don't even know what happened. It like mistaken where I was point warping. It like did it twice. I'm making slowly but surely making quick work of this one, which actually doesn't make sense when I said that out loud. I'm really just waiting until my armature comes back. But do I want to eat? I slightly do, but I don't know. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yes. Oh yes. It is time. It don't even matter. You know why? You're dead. You're done now. It's so beautiful. Sad ending though, the Ravis, honestly. You know, because like I said, it's just
a sorry end for the High Command. For anyone.
The man lost not only his mother, his sister, couldn't accept that Noctis was a king, finally accepted it, and then it seems like Noctis was the one that killed him, even though it was Arden. Arden played this man. Like, just, that man had a rough time in this game.
Look alive! Company!
Dang, more? Oh yeah, I remember this shit. It's gonna be a battle. Not really, though. You ready to see some goodness?
You should be able to handle this, right?
You're right. I'm waiting for all of them to get by. There we go. I couldn't get them all in, but phew. Let's get stuff back. Oh yes, this is beautiful. Oh yes, and they're all bunched up. Yes. I feel like that one didn't actually even hit anyone. Nah, it will. Oh yeah, and they're all bunched up now. This has to get some people. We got a decent amount that time around.
What about you? We'll manage somehow. Just get moving.
Okay. Still gotta wait for the elevator to come. There we go. You know, I wonder if you could just sit here and grind. Like, you could grind for levels or something. I don't even know.
Hangar gate closing. Please stand clear.
Let's go. I mean, I'm hearing them like get hit. Bro, let me leave. Oh my, I was about to say, the freaking Iron Giant was doing his one gravitational pull move. And I was like, this man's really going to prevent me. You know, how many times do I have to blast that man in a different dimension and he's still alive? Like, come on. Unless there's multiple of that guy, then I guess. You know, honestly, I think they would be capable of that. They would be capable of killing all of them. Gate. I'm not even lying to closed. You. Even without Noctis, I feel
don't
like
die on me.
They would actually be capable of killing everything. Because you gotta be a top-notch, you know, servant of the king to get to that position, so honestly, I do think they would be able to fend for themselves. Even though I don't know if they would be spawning forever, but I feel like they would get through it.
Those who died for you, do you ever wonder what went through their minds? Can you even recall their final words?
Now, Arden, like, is forever reading a poem.
I'll come back for you all. I swear.
Alright. Time to get this crystal. Time to get the crystal and obtain that power. Obtain that power.
How far does this go?
Man, you just started running. Why you complaining?
The crystal had better be here.
Bitch, do you know
something? Everyone's counting on it.
You know, I'm not gonna lie. That shit don't even look like a crystal. I think I said this in a previous video, but like, it don't really look like a crystal to me. Kind of. I don't know. Close up. I guess inside of it does, but it looks kind of weird.
Allow me to regale you with a tale. In an age long past, an incurable scourge ravaged mankind. A tiny menace that twisted men into monsters the likes of which you've seen. Eleusis lived a savior who could cure the afflicted. His body would come to host myriad demons. Countless lives be spared. But a jealous king, one chosen by the crystal, ostracized and demonized this healer of the people, making a true monster of him. I gave you my name earlier, but you should know that it was not the name given to me at birth. Arden Lucis Kylam is my proper name.
Boom!
You'll never guess whose name this Unio was. Killing his mortal will bring me satisfaction. Play the crystal's power. Arise as its champion. Only once the crystal and king are no more. I know redemption. Come back soon. I shall keep your friends covered until you are.
This is the crazy part. When you first get here, you're like, whoa, is that what's happening right now? Like, you're extra confused because the crystal literally sucked in Noctis. And you kind of feel bad for Arden, because whoever the opposing person was, it seems like Arden's job was basically what the Oracle is, and to rid and heal people from the darkness, pretty much. And, you know, evidently when you get rid of the darkness, it has to go somewhere, and it goes within you. So when you heal so many people and relinquish so many people of the darkness, that means that much darkness went inside you, which, like he said, made a monster of him. And whoever the opposing, you know, actual Azunia is, basically, I guess, is the cause of this. So you kind of feel bad for Arden in a way. Now, I'm not entirely sure how the story worked with this, but it was so cool to know that, you know, Arden is actually a Lucius Kylum, which pretty much that means he's a blood relative of Noctis. So you can tell that he feels betrayed by his own family, so he just wants to rid the king and the crystal, because just like Ravis at the beginning, I feel like Arden wanted to be that chosen king but could not do so. You know, he wasn't chosen, and well, you know, I think that's how it was, or maybe not, I don't know. It's hard to really explain and gather your thoughts around, at least for me. We're floating into whatever this may be. Well, I guess inside the crystal. You know, for as small as shit that crystal was, it's pretty
cool. The fate of this world falls to the King of Kings.
But,
his providence,
I'm gonna shut up because he's gonna speak some real stuff and you guys need to listen. So I'm going to shut up. But that is Bahamut.
So it is ordained, the revelation of Bahamut. The heart of the crystal, wherein lies the soul of the star. And it is in this place that the king will gain the power to fulfill his calling. They stand against the darkness and abide in hope, sustained by faith unfaltering that their king shall arise and bring deliverance. By the covenants awakened, the six have seen the coming of the prophesied hour. A time when the crystal shall have shed the entirety of its light unto the ring. Only then, once the sacred ring is replete, can the true king complete his ascension. And only by the true king's hand can the immortal accursed be banished and the light restored to this world.
Alright, let's see. Who's the providence?
It is the sole means to ending the immortal accursed. A power greater than even that of the six. Purifying all by the light of the crystal and the glaives of rulers past.
So basically Noctis is
a prophet. Only at the throne can the chosen receive it, and only at the cost of a life his own.
So I'm assuming Arden is the immortal accursed?
A man cursed with life eternal, whose immortality stems from the self-same scourge that wrought the demons. One so impure of body and soul was deemed unworthy of the crystal's light and forbidden to ascend. His mind twisted by spite and bent on revenge, the usurper came to bring darkness down upon our world.
So I guess I feel a little less
bad for him. The true king, chosen by the crystal and guarded by his forebears, can end the accursed's madness. The King of Kings shall be granted. granted the power to banish the darkness, but the blood price must be paid. To cast out the usurper and usher in Dawn's light will cost the life of the Chosen. Many sacrificed all for the king, so must the king sacrifice himself for all. Now enter into reflection. Let the light of providence shine within.
All right, so there was a lot said in there, and basically, we basically have to die, you know, to do everything and rid the world of darkness and purge the scourge. We have to, you know, at the cost of our life, pretty much what it is, which is crazy. But as the Chosen King, and yep, you can see all the memories, because he knows what he has to do, and he's come to terms and accepted the fact, you know, losing Luna Freya, losing his father, he's accepted the fact that he has to sacrifice himself to save the world. And I love that, I really do. I mean, the flack that this game gets almost irritates me.
The light waxes full. Go forth to the kingdom where the usurper awaits. Reclaim the throne and fulfill the calling of the true king.
So what I realize after hearing all that, so Arden was the first chosen, you know, the first chosen king, but he was unfit to do so. So therefore he was like replaced, you know, with Noctis. Oh, I guess that's Umbra, I'm assuming. But yeah, I mean, the story's so deep, and people says there's plot holes that, oh, I don't understand this. I feel like the people that complain that there, you know, is stuff missing, and there is stuff missing. But what people complain about so much about stuff missing, in reality, is you're just not understanding, because I'm seeing, like, very valid points of what they're saying. But those points can be explained in the actual game itself. So, partly I feel like people give this game too much of a hard, just a hard knock of like, nah, it's not good. You know, same with Final Fantasy 13, but I give them a little bit more credit for that one because I agree with the people that say they don't like it. I just do. So that's kind of how it is. Oh, by the way, that said the Chosen King's calling, you know. Ooh. What's this? Oh, I was confused. I was like, hold on, how did Prompto take pictures? I was not there, but I forgot. Chapter 14, Homecoming. Noctis leaves his prison to find himself in Angleguard. His father's ship is moored at shore, none the worse for wear. It now carries him back to Golden Key, back to his kingdom. The final chapter is now at hand, and you know, it's kind of bittersweet a little bit, because I realize, for me personally, I realize that after this episode, more than likely, I'm done playing the game, because, I mean, I think, see, when this video goes up, there's going to be DLC that's already been out since Tuesday, but I don't know whether or not I paid $20 extra just to play that or not, because all it gives you that I don't have is, you know, extra bosses to fight, but that adds nothing to the story, really. Like, it adds a little bit, but the only real thing that's gonna, you know, make me happy to actually want to buy it is more episodes, which they're doing in 2019. People were pissed about it, but whatever.
Man, how long was I out?
It must be a while, because my boy got a beard. A small one, but it's a beard. The World of Ruin. Reunite with the others. But yeah, like I said, it's kind of bittersweet. Same with like Super, if you think about it. Like, this game, after I complete this, I don't think I'll be playing it. You know, and Dragon Ball Super, after the last episode's there, you got no choice but you can't watch it. It's over. Which sucks. So we got some murdering to do. Man, level 7? Bruh. I don't even want to warp strike yet. Look at this. Bruh. Y'all some suck right there. They won't let me switch out my Ragnarok, but it's okay. I need... Let's see, which... yeah, we'll go with the strongest. I was about to go with Ulrich's daggers. Alright. Man, everything is in ruin. Standing. Well, I guess... Well, I can't say in ruin. Just rather the darkness has taken over at this point. Nah, you're dead. You're done now. Look at that. Beauty. They can't even give me a good grade in finesse because it's over Tonberries. Thing about Tonberries, they do a lot of damage and their defense is extremely high. And as you can tell, you gotta be fast with parrying them. You can't wait it out. They don't get staggered, so you can't get greedy with your attacks. You have to attack them, you know, basically with the parry and that's it. You can't just get greedy with it. Because there's other Tonberries, especially in the Menace Dungeons, that are stronger. And you don't want to be greedy with them. They'll murder. Wait, what? They're giving me a summon option? Nah, I got a summon. Two Tonberries I can kill on my own? Nah, we need a god to go ahead and finish these two off for us. Who are they giving me? Oh, shit, Rama? Alright, let's get it. Rama looking nice. Like, I know he probably isn't older, but he just looks older. Even though he looks the exact same, but he kind of looks different a little bit. And he really just blew his staff right in there. Well, whoa, it killed other people too. God damn. Rama, I didn't actually... Oh, whoa. All A report card right there. Look at that. It's just like I was in school. Look at that. Your boy finally getting some shit. It's Naga again. Nah. You gotta go in a different dimension, ho. Wait, whoa. Whoa. What's up with the... Nah, you going in a different dimension, ho. Bang. Yeah, Nagas, they can't live in my world. They gotta go somewhere else. Kind of like training right now for the final battle. I'm not really grinding for levels. I'm more just, you know, giving a little show before we actually end the game. Give a little something. Oh yeah. Oh yes, we're murdering. The sexiness of our attacks is ridiculously nice. I'm so proud. We got an all A report card. We've been getting C minuses, D's, and all that on finesse. We finally got an A. I love it. It's kind of fitting. The final episode is the actual episode where we actually get a good grade. Isn't that funny? Ooh. Two iron giants, huh? They're not red giants, though, so I ain't even worried. You know why? You ready? Oh, I don't even have enough. I don't even have enough freaking imp. Or MP to do this. I'll wait, because y'all gonna get sent to a different dimension. Oh, yeah. Bang! Right there. My voice cracked. Y'all didn't hear it. See, I find that stuff so awesome. Like, no lie. Alright. We got 2.16 miles to go to get to Hammerhead. It's gonna be a little walk. But we will murder everything on the way there. There's a demon wall. So this is the thing we faced in Gladio's DLC. Oh, let's go. Let's fight. Oh, shit. Oh, that meant... Oh, he... Okay, so we can't do that against Gladio. Oh, I understand why they don't give you these items to cure purification. So I guess that's why that attack doesn't work on Gladio. You know, reasons, but it's cool. So gotta be careful now. I'm in stasis now, I didn't even realize that. We murdering. It's not a lot, but we murdering. I'm using elixir to get my MP back. Oh, it hit me? Oh, goddamn. See, I have all these items for the reason that in the Menace Dungeon, you don't want to get turned to stone. You need all these items. So I was prepared at that moment, and, you know, it's good to still have him. Because I bought up a lot when I first did the Minas Dungeons, and I really didn't need all of them that I bought. And also, I did some time quests to get some items, so, you know, I didn't need every item I got, but it still was nice to have. Look at Umbra keeping up. Look at little Umbra. Little Umby.
Man, look at these little hoes. They ain't gonna be able to do nothing.
Necromancer is more like pussies. Yeah, that's right. Stay over there. They're looking at me like, aren't you gonna come and fight us? You're fighting everyone else. Nah. Ain't good enough for this. You know, I really do like Noctis's look. I seen this little post on Twitter. It was like, it was comparing Final Fantasy VII to Final Fantasy XV. It was like, Cloud then versus Cloud now. Basically his progression through the, I think his progression through the story. And they were like, Cloud then had his, pretty much looked like a fighter, looked like he was ready to go, you know. And then Cloud now, and he was like a stuck up, he looked like he didn't care, he didn't look like he even wanted to fight and all that. It was funny. And then Noctis then was the way Cloud now is, and then Cloud then is the way Noctis is now, which is cool. Because, I mean, it makes sense, you know. Noctis matured, Cloud,
what is it, well, boy?
Cloud really stayed the same in my opinion, but it was still a funny picture nonetheless.
A truck.
We about to hitchhike. I'm about to get murdered. Yo, boy, can I get a ride there or something? Excuse me, sir. Can I get a ride? You want to be like, hey, yeah. Boy, go home.
It's me, Talcott.
It's little
my
Talcott.
Grandpa served the Amicidia family.
That grandpa didn't do shit. He just sat there.
Talcott?
He sat there for one cutscene, then dead he was.
No way. Yes way. Welcome back, Your Majesty.
You wonder, though, at this point, you're wondering, like, how long was this man gone? Because, like,
yes,
when a little boy...
That's right.
When a little boy turns into a little man, just a you're second. Like, how long has that been?
Said he wants to have a word with you.
He can have it in person.
He said you can have it in person.
Damn.
Okay.
Stays in prison for a little bit, now he doesn't even like phones. What's wrong with you there, bud? I wonder if my collectibles still stayed in the car. Yep.
Wow.
So these five Cactuar figurines basically are side quests, and I had to do them because I wanted to do every single side quest, and I think it's been 10 years. But yeah, I had to do all the side quests to get these, and I don't know if it was an achievement for it. But I just felt like doing it, and I did. And they stuck there, so that's cool.
For Miss Cindy. You know, back at the garage. She's a tough one, but when she needs a little
extra muscle out
on the road...
10 years from now, you don't even see exactly what, what Cindy even looked like.
The guys said they're near Hammerhead right now, so we'll be meeting them there.
Or Iris, and I feel like 10 years, Iris and Cindy wouldn't, you know, age well.
Nighttime, nonstop.
Lestalum even Aranea,
thanks to the power plant, so just about everyone's taken refuge there.
Hey, look at all these demons. Everywhere else they afraid though. They lucky Talcott driving me. I get up, be all there.
Forcing
ass.
The people to move out.
It take
people
hours, but I'll
by
beat
the garage
them.
At Hammerhead from time to time, but it usually isn't for repairs.
See, a guy with a fire sword. That is an iron giant.
A slayer station. A base for demon hunting.
The
garage
next step
is still
up.
Open though. One of the few places that is.
So, Sid. Still alive and kicking.
He's kicking all right, just not as hard as before. He hasn't really been himself lately, at least not since he moved out to Lestalum. Someone suggested he move the garage there too, but old man Sid wasn't having it. He called it a big fat chocobo turd of an idea.
I like how we're just having a nonchalant conversation while all these demons out there probably want to murder us.
Miss Cindy said she didn't mind either way, so the garage will probably stay put for a while. And without any tinkering to do, Ignis's gourmet seafood is about all Sid has left to look forward to.
You know, Sid already looked old as freak, so 10 plus years, that man probably got wrinkles on his wrinkles. He drooping. I wish I could see him.
Gladio and the others.
See, that's one thing they missed out on. Is in this last chapter, instead of just what's about to happen, they should have made it we see everyone, like have last goodbyes to everyone that's still there.
We tried to stop him.
Because I would love to see Iris the Demon Slayer. I would love to see, you know, how RNA is doing, how Sid's doing, you know, all these
people. I'm afraid not. But that being said, he gets by pretty well on his own. Gladio and Prompto usually hunt on their own as well. It isn't often you see the three of them together nowadays. They still work as a team every once in a while, but each has his own set of tasks to keep him busy.
Is that so?
Kind of sucks, if you think about it a little bit, because it's not that they're not friends anymore, but
you've arrived, Your Majesty.
Tasks changed, the, so the group is no longer the group anymore.
Don't worry.
They're all waiting for Noctis.
I won't be going anywhere. If you have any other questions, please don't hesitate to ask.
Alright, we are finally here. Well,
on black screen. You wanna change? Black screen? Black screen? You wanna change? Black screen? I was about to raise my voice there, kid. In Hammerhead. Darkness overtaking the world, but sexy boy is back in town. I gotta say, Noctis, like, you know, where did he get a comb to fix his hair? Because that man came, he was on that boat, and then came back out, put on some clothes right off the boat, put on some clothes, dirty as fuck, but his hair looked better.
That's all you have to say for yourself after all this time?
Gladio, sexy as fuck. No homo.
It's you! It's really you!
I hadn't realized.
Well, well.
Everyone got a beard except Ignis. Ignis, like, I don't need a beard to look manly. I pull all the hoes.
Not like I wanted to.
Well, well.
We've got catching up to do. Let's head inside.
So basically, I see Ignis is, you know, he gets around now perfectly. Which is insane. How you get around perfectly blind without even a cane or anything is beyond me, but Ignis is the one that can do it. What about last meal? What are we doing here? Oh, I forgot. This ain't even the restaurant anymore. Alright. Dang, that sucks. That sucks. Alright. Is there anything to check out? I'm trying to remember. I don't think there's anything to do in this last little spot. I think it's just time to go. Heading for that Crown City. We're ready to end it all. Make sure everything's good. We got everything. We got everything. We got everything. I just now realized Gladio's impulse is back down to level 1. I had that shit all the way up. Every skill was maxed. They changed it.
Well, fellas, we're homeward bound at last. Time to suit up.
Finally get to rock these threads.
Wear them with pride.
Yeah. Just hope they still fit.
Well, they about to fit. Let's get it. Alright. Oh, one last meal. What are we eating for the last meal? What's a good meal to commemorate our journey? You know, honestly, I'm feeling some cup noodles. You know, it was something we joked about, but I feel like it's a good way to end the story. Like, no lie. I feel like it's a good way to end it. Now, in all reality, if I wanted an actual last meal, I would choose something a lot better. But, you know, for the shrimp, though, I don't know about that one. But no, for the actual end of the Let's Play, it's a good callback. Man, bittersweet. Man, look at all these guys. Glad you're enjoying it. You know, like, I do get a little emotional with this. Just because you kind of, you know, everyone got those friends. Those friends that you can, you know, that has your back at all times. And that's how this story is for me, at least. After 10 long years of solitude, Noctis is reunited with his friends, breaking camp for the final time. They return to the Crown City of Insomnia, where the Chosen King will make his stand and restore the light to the world. Man, we're finally coming to an end here. It was a good Let's Play, though. It was really good Let's Play. Coleman Gear, sponsored, you know. People were mad that Coleman, well, that Final Fantasy even let, you know, them use Coleman in their game. And I'm like, why? If you're going to camp, you might as well do it right, you know? So, That's another thing. Like, I feel like everyone just attacked this game for almost anything. And I'm just in my head like, shut up. Y'all complained about everything. It's done. It's time to stop. But man, I'm proud of myself. The more this goes, but I don't even know how much longer it's going to be for this episode. I know it's going to be a long one. Oh yeah, look at us. Even though these costumes dirty as shit.
Home sweet.
Or these uniforms. Well, yeah, everyone else is clean. At long last. Mine is dirty. Hey, y'all ain't clean mine? The sure freak is this? What the next fuck is up, this?
The Citadel.
What the?
Yeah.
Everyone. Oh, this is music is so beautiful. Good thing about this music that I don't think people realize. The one. Like, they kept a lot of aspects from the original Final Fantasy Versus 13, which it was the original game.
Yeah.
But, you know, they kept a decent amount of aspects, but they got rid of a lot. You know, they changed up a lot of stuff and switched it up. But one thing they kept was that song. I don't know if they kept a lot of the soundtrack. You see how badass I'm looking? I'm just trying to show off. But no, the final world is a perfect place to put this song. Which is kind of the first song. I think the first trailer, that was the song that played. Did you see this? I'm like eating them alive. Look at this. Watch this. Bang. Oh, yeah. It's beautiful.
I've been fought together like this in ages.
Really takes you back, doesn't it?
This stuff's weird. Struggled before, but now nothing. Oh, what are we fighting over there? That man already ready. He was like, I'm ready for you. Yeah, this music's so beautiful. I love it. It's one thing Final Fantasy can never get wrong. They will never make a bad soundtrack. Oh shit. I didn't expect that. I didn't know the match already started. Okay. Gotta learn his moveset again. There we go. Let's get that parry. Don't need to heal yet. I'm like trying to stop hitting because you can't dodge him in it.
Much obliged.
I like how prompt out. See, that's the story of the game. If you ever actually play the story, you know, normal levels and everything, Prompto will always be the first to die. That man is always dying. Always. It's annoying. Especially in the men's dungeons, because like that's the person you want alive sometimes in. That's the man who always dies. You're making me kind of waste my MP. Bomb does that again. So we gotta revive him. I'm busy. Oh, whoa. Hold on. I parry. What y'all doing with that? Let's go ahead and do some damage. This should do a little bit. Alright. Not too bad. I need to break the limit. Limit break all these guys' moves. Haven't done that. I should have done that before I even started this playthrough so we could do more damage than 9999. So we'd be making even quicker work. I'm learning. I'm learning how to fight him. Oh, there's no war points. Ah, that was a bad mistake. Oh boy, I don't even get. Wait, no, I have one hit. No, I'm liking this. Final world, and we're doing, you know, minimal damage, but it's a good fight. It's an honest, good fight. Oh, hold on, there's a summon now? You can do that now? Oh, I gotta check this out. Who we got? Shiva, huh? I thought she was only for that one fight. You're about to see it later, but Shiva, she can do it now? Now I'm confused. How does her summon work in other, like, normal fights? I'm curious. This is cool. This is honestly cool. Diamond Dust, alright. And we already know about this, but... alright, so she basically just murdered.
Well...
It didn't even look like she did a lot of damage. It just said 1,000. Like only yesterday, 300 and something, and that's all. Oh my Sounds god. Like he's all grown up now. Okay, that, I bet Jared would be that was proud. Scary as shit. I'm not even gonna lie to you. I'm just kidding. I like that song so much. Right. Nice, Iggy. No time for combat. All right, let's get this. Let me get my MP. Oh wait, no, it was already back. I didn't know this. Oh shit. I'm sick of these mother. Keep doing all this damage to me. It's like, come on, man. Yes. Yes. Block. Give me that. Yeah, we're getting it. That last freaking enemy though was annoying. Since we got a warp point, I'm gonna use up some MP. Just a little bit. Oh. It's best to do warp strikes with this, even though it's not even doing its purpose. Oh yeah, do you, Prompto? There you go. Murdered. Burned it so hard, left tarantula. Even I think that's what it normally does. Alright. We're making quick work.
Guess we've still got a little fight left in us.
It's worn down, but still the same.
Just like I remember.
Always came in handy.
Bruh, can I push this button? I was about to say, like, goddamn.
Let's see that it
is. I was struggling so hard. Oh yes, oh, if I would have got that parry, I did it too slow. Concentrating a little bit, and I shouldn't. Like, these fights aren't even that big of a deal. They wouldn't be hard at all, but I'm like trying to concentrate. Trying to make me look better than I am, you know? Alright, hey, when it does it. I locked on to a different person. Yeah, if I keep getting shot by those, it will add up. That's why I'm dodging every once in a while. Because even though it's only doing 40 damage, that 40 damage will add up.
Time to say goodbye.
All right. Okay, that wasn't the best, but it worked.
Kingly confidence you've acquired.
And it only took you 10 years.
10 years, and they all still got the same humor. I love it. Come on, push the button. Goodness sakes. Bruh, he didn't even push the button. That man pushed the wall. They must know secrets I don't know. Alright. Every step.
Only a little goddamn,
hold on. I
didn't
see that. I thought that was Cerberus for a minute. I was like, don't tell me they put the DLC in for me.
No, they didn't. Can't make it without you.
Yes, sir, your majesty.
Alright, let's go ahead and beat ourselves. What is this? What is this? Come on. A behemoth king. Alright, well, we're gonna kill it. We're killing everything we come in front of. Nothing but a thing. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Murder. 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 It's over. It is over. It's time. Okay, he's actually living through a lot. Not even, oh, wait, no, we broke him. Yep, it's over now. Oh yeah, you dead. Oh, you dead. Oh, you is dead. Come on, Noctis, that's enough. Goddamn, I wasn't even doing that. Towards the end, he was just wanting to murder. Alright. Alright. Okay, open the damn door. Noctis. My gosh, having so much trouble. Alright, we're getting close to the final battle, but it's still bothering me that Noctis is, like, dirty, and everyone else is clean. I used the Mega Elixir just because to get us all full health. I don't want any issues, even though I don't see us having trouble with literally anything else. I mean, not that we were having trouble before.
Ifrit, the Infernian. He doesn't share the Glacian's fondness for mankind. But you can expect a warm welcome. I shall await you above.
Alright. Y'all recognize this? This is how the beginning of the game started. And you remember when I said, remember this scene? Well, here you go.
He's gonna bring the heat.
It's literally they really showed second to the final battle at the beginning of the game, which is weird but cool.
Hang in there, buddy. Stay down. We'll keep him busy.
Knox, over here. Quickly, before he strikes again.
Here it comes!
I find this so awesome.
I got your back!
Here you go. Let's go!
And see, when he said let's go, that was when basically it zoomed out and then the beginning of the game started. But now, let's go means let's go and kick some ass. I'm warp striping back just because I don't want him to grab me. I don't know what's his. Oh, yep. Exact wrong moment to warp strike, but we're good. We're good. We did so much damage that we already got our summon. I was about to say hello. Oh boy, it's our bud, Bahamut. Why I like Bahamut so much? Because in Final Fantasy 13, one of the cool characters, in my opinion, was Fang, and her summon. You know, you had to do these trials to obtain your summon, and her summon was Bahamut. Basically, that right there, she wrote that. I think it was a different form, but that was her summon. It was so cool. Look at that shit. It's so awesome. All right, hello, Karimzi. Welcome to your personal shout out. Ultima Sword. This is so awesome. Badass this looks. My man's Noctis knows what's up. It's over. Well, that's the game, guys. We beat the game. It was beautiful. Pretty easy boss fight. I was kidding with you.
So even that wasn't enough.
So basically, Ifrit's personal story is basically, you know, Shiva and Ifrit were pretty much, they were in love. And Arden fucked with that, you know. He fucked with that, put a toxin in his mind. Corrupted Ifrit. I like calling him Ifrit, but the way Arden said it kind of made me want to say it like that. But no, Ifrit, he corrupted him. And that's why he looks the way he is, kind of darkness looking. And, you know, that's why we're fighting. If it wasn't for Arden, he wouldn't have a god on his side. We would be going after Arden immediately. Did he hit him? Oh, sure, he hit him. Oh, he fell down the wrong way. You want to use Ignis's Libra just to get his weakness there. So then he can not be on fire the whole time, and I can actually do some damage.
Feels like I'm just hitting air, and the flames grow hotter.
Can he hit him? Oh, he did.
What can we do to kill
him? Do some damage. He's at least a little bit. Got me in the corner. Too bad I ain't gonna stand for it. You know, I never had to fight down here. Normally, they're not down here, but He hit me hard on that one. There you go, Idris. I know you're blind, but it'd be nice if you would get into the fight. But it's okay. This is all we need you for anyways, I guess. Best man, too. Not gonna lie. I blocked. When you hear the music though, it complements this fight so well. Alright, Ignis, do your thing. Oh, he getting some. He getting that perfect side. He's like, nah, I ain't missing. He did miss. Did he miss? Nah, he got him. Oh shit, that did some damage I didn't mean to have. I don't need to heal. Oh, I think Ignis healed me. He healed me a little bit. Oh, hey, Agnes is down here. At the last second, though, but it's time. It is time. All right. Look at this. Look at this combo, man. Look at this combo. Hit combo, 91 hit. Unbelievable. That's how the fighting games would be. You know, if he would have hit me with that, I would have been in danger. Like, he would have probably, well, at least made me have to use a potion, but it didn't matter. Here's the real first summon. Like, this is the first time you're supposed to see Shiva, not when I did. That's why I was so confused, because I was like, how is the summon gonna play out, because it plays out differently in here. You'll see, still Diamond Dust, but watch what happens. You know, when you learn about their past, that really signifies the kiss goodbye right there. You don't realize that until you actually learn the story a little bit more, and you wouldn't know that because in the original base game they didn't add in the, you know, Ifrit was Shiva's, you know, lover. But and that right there, that dialogue was not in the base game either. So, you know, they added a lot.
Thanks, Shiva. Thanks, Bane.
I made a promise, one that I intend to keep.
All right. The final staircase. It's good to see you, staircase. But sadly, this is our goodbye. It's the last time I'm gonna use you. No, I'm seriously like, I'm a little sad that we're completing this. I want to keep it going.
Last, the Citadel. The throne is just up ahead.
Even though I do believe I'll do the Comrades expansion.
It's all lit up.
But I don't know.
Guess he's expecting company.
He wants this as bad as we do.
Think the elevator's working?
Huh. Sure looks like
yeah,
it.
Y'all some ladies.
He is really taking us by the hand. Nah. He'll save our legs the walk up.
Come on, push the button, Noctis. God dang. My man's dirty. Can't open a gate. Can't push buttons. Like, what can you do? Gladio? I was about to say. Better get out of the way. Bro, that man didn't push the button. Excuse me, Noctis. Do you actually even know what a button is? Like, my God. Alright, that's that noise you hear. Basically, what happens if you want some the secret weapons, you go back outside.
It's outside.
And yeah. Go all the way to the beginning where you and came. So there'll be a pyromancer. You kill like him. You'll get Ulrich's daggers, I believe, back. Which is a person off of King's Glaive. And his daggers aren't too bad. Tonight. I mean, they're not the strongest, but they're not too bad. They're just cool to have. Right. The cure for insomnia. Which is kind of funny. Is that they're like the cure for sleep.
Remember
the cure for
we
rest
in front of King Regis,
you know,
the day we left.
That was the last.
Well, the
we
cure for not
in.
Being able to sleep, not yeah. being able to rest.
They even let me
basically
in
letting the world rest farther. From the darkness. Well, that's basically what I understand.
Shall we? Knocked. Yeah, but
you remember those photos?
Hold on a sec.
It's time to see those purpose
Pronto.
Of it.
Can I see your photos?
Yeah.
I just need one to take with me.
Oh, yeah, I get it.
It's been a long journey, but
you can
let's go ahead
take
and look
whichever
through
you
these
like.
Photos. All right. They gonna load?
A shot of us in combat might be cool.
Yeah, Gladio, well, that would be cool, but sadly, what the freak? Shot. Like, what is this? Bro, they're all, like, black. That might sound racist. I'm not against black, but come on. Nah, but seriously, like, what the hell? Don't tell me they're all like this.
Something catch your eye there, bud?
Bruh.
Think of all the places
they only saved two.
I can't beat that.
I can pick them, of all four of but... us
together.
That the one you want?
They're not this loaded. Is it. It's only these two. Listen, is that a sign? Knocked. I mean... That one is a good one, but...
I'm sure it's really hard to settle on just one.
It is. Sadly, because we didn't get a choice. That's you know, that kind of irks my nerves.
No backsies?
Let me see. We're going backsies prompt, though, just because I want to see if they load. That really sucks.
Actually, let me have another look at those.
Right. Let's look at this. They really... Only those two are going to load. That is crazy. You know, but maybe it's a sign... Because those two,
no car like the Regalia.
One of those actually, not even those two, back. That one with us four yes. is probably the best photo that I would have probably chosen anyways. I don't know, but
that the one you want?
It is a nice photo. It's
that's the one?
It shows no the fun backsies. Of that sombrero, you know, the funniness. It shows everything. So yeah, I'm going with that one. It kind of sucks they all didn't load, but we got a good one.
Is that?
I'm afraid you're out of luck. The throne brings you here. It seats only one.
The funny thing is, that's like a callback to the beginning when they first met. Because he says the same thing. There. He says, when you first meet him, Golden Key, he's like, I'm afraid you're out of luck. The boats bring you here.
Locked. How I have waited for this. Longer than you could ever know. Tonight, the dreams of the blood royal come to an end.
Spites all that's kept him going.
Talk about a grudge.
Arden sits the throne. Not for long. This is my ascension.
What did you do? They have no place in this. The Battle of Kings. Come, Noctis.
Now, at first, I was like, did he just murder him that quick? But, of course, that wouldn't be the case. What the hell? Wait. Drakok? Is that his name? Drakthor? I'm just kidding. Look at all this, though. That's Ulrich. That was Regis, Lunafreya, and then Lunafreya's mother. I forgot her name. All right.
It ends now.
Yep. You're right, Noctis. It's time. It is time. The final battle awaits. Alright. Look at that. Look at this. Oh my god.
The once helpless and hapless prince. Is he now ready to claim his crown? Don't let us down.
So you can already tell. At this point, you couldn't, you know, you didn't understand what he meant by he's a, Lucius Calum. He has all 13 of his own royal arms. Let's go.
So you are the chosen king, but you are a second choice at best.
I'm like concentrating that I don't even have to. Ooh, he tried to catch me, a boy on fire. He did catch me on fire. Too bad you ain't do no damn. Okay, bud. That's enough hitting me. Freak's wrong with you. Point of work real quick. A score to settle with your boy. Bang.
Do you like what I've done with the world? I twisted it all just for you.
This is so cool though. Awesome. I mean, it's the perfect battle, bro. I like it. I mean, there's been harder bosses in the past, of like in-game bosses, but this is a good one. It's not high on the difficulty level, but it is. It is a fun one. Oh, we got him now. Your boy about to murder. Oh yeah, you lucky. Nobody like a little hope. Yeah, I got you. Nah. Right, I press parry. Oh, you think you're cool, don't you? You think you're cool, don't you? Oh, you wanna taunt? You wanna taunt me? Yeah, boy. Nasty. Let me get that. Bang, bang, bang. Yeah, this ain't what you thought, was it? You like this damage, don't you? You don't even know what's happening. You don't even know what's happening. You're like, what happened? He turned the tables. Yeah, boy, nasty. Oh, yeah, get on that ground, little hoe. Yeah. Now, we are doing good, though. We're getting our ass beat for a minute. You know, kind of sad. Are you trying? Is he toying with me now? Yeah, let me get this real quick damage. Oh, my. You see how scary this man look when the blizzard's on him?
Don't worry. It's far from over.
Well, let's have it then. You and your crystal. Against all I have become.
Power of light!
I feel like Noctis post, you know, crystal. He sounds so badass in my opinion. Like, he really does. And this is just such a cool boss fight. I don't even care what anyone says. I will say, like people griped about, it doesn't have that difficulty factor, but that was just this game, like honestly. Yeah, I don't think it was suited for difficulty, but rather suited for looks in a way. You can understand that. Because it wasn't hard there. It took away all the strategy. Because that was one thing. Even how bad people said Final Fantasy 13 was, it still had that sense of strategy and you had to actually, you know, think about your moves. And this, you get 20 potions, 20 elixirs, some remedies, you beat the game. It don't matter the level. You could be level 1 and still probably beat the game. I'm sure it exists. Oh yeah, let's get it.
Kings of yore are on hand, calling you forth to oblivion.
Right, final battle. Well, final little fight. Oh, yeah, get knocked down. Father died.
You were off playing with your friends.
Goddamn.
When your beloved died, you lay watching. You think 10 years is a long time?
This is so cool, in my opinion, because you use all 13 weapons.
In darkness for ages.
This is so badass. Like, honestly, it is. It's so badass.
So, that is how you would end it.
This is good. Oh, that stopped abruptly. Hello? Oh, I was about to say, like, is the audio okay? That stopped like extra weird. Didn't do a fade out. It just stopped immediately.
Now it is over, Majesty. What will you do? Banish the demons and bring peace? Erase me from history once more.
This time, you can rest in peace. Close your eyes. Forevermore.
I will await you in the beyond.
See, you know, with Arden's final words, it sounds like this is what he wanted, honestly. You know, all the stuff he was doing in Noctis was getting them ready. Because, yes, he was a bad man. But it sounds like he was working him towards actually ridding the world of, you know, the demons and all that, purging the world, making sure the darkness is no longer, and also freeing this man, letting him, you know, die in peace. And whether or not that's true or not, whether or not that's actually what Arden wanted, I have no clue. But it sounds like, you know, a good theory, honestly. That was a good fight. That was a good fight. It was. And, I mean, overall, the game was fun. The game was fun. It really was. Look at them graphics. Look at them graphics. And it ain't even the overly realistic graphics of Final Fantasy yet. Well. And they still look nice.
Yeah. Here we are.
It's all you.
No turning back now.
Prompto. Gladio. Ignis. I leave it to you. Walk tall, my friends. Godspeed, and take care, Majesty.
Again, these final cutscenes, I don't want to talk at all. I mean, I'm talking the pauses, but I mean, and then the credits, but in these actual final scenes, I don't even want to say a word. I want you guys to experience it, you know, for you guys itself, kind of, in a way. Y'all ready for some beautiful ass graphics though? I mean, they're already beautiful, but y'all ready for some extremely like nut busting graphics? Like, it's about to happen. It's gonna look so beautiful. That's what I love about Final Fantasy. They always go hard on the beginning cutscene and the ending cutscenes. It's so funny. But watch how beautiful it looks.
It took me a while. I'm ready now. I love you all. Luna. Guys. Dad. The time we had together, I cherish. Kings of Lucis. Come to me!
Such a wonderful cutscene. Like, honestly, this is no talking. I felt like I should, you know, actually talk about it. But it really is. Sounds creepy.
There's King Regis, his father.
When you play this for the first time and this happens, you're like, so sad.
Not even alive, but it ain't even the saddest part yet. He ain't even there yet.
It was a, you know, those last cutscenes always get you, but, I mean, it's a very good game. It was, it honestly was a very good game. But here's another good part. You remember how it started when they were broken down?
Can it? Ready?
Here it is. Steady. But instead, there's gonna be that song again. So, to not get copyrighted, you know, even though it doesn't really matter, but I don't want Square Enix to, you know,
like,
copyright strike me, and that, and like, you don't want to strike.
We let ourselves get carried away.
Now we bad.
Look, these things happen.
Let's just hope this isn't some omen.
Gladio, do me a favor.
What?
Push this thing by yourself.
All by myself?
You won't even notice if we just let go.
Pronto, you know what? I'm gonna let it play through.
Think about it.
Freak Save it. Some breath for pushing.
Ignis, come on, time to switch.
Even no, though, hold on, actually, we just switched back there. This is the bad and thing. My photos didn't save, how do I know that the... It's gonna be, well, a couple of them saved, I guess. Because there's supposed to be a lot of photos. Let's see how long it goes. Alright. There's three of them. The song's so good. It honestly is. It's one of the best versions of Stand By Me, honestly. See, there's supposed to be photos right here, but, well, the game freaked me. I don't know why. Probably all the updates and stuff, so it was like, nah. These photos, nah, they ain't gonna work. At least we get a couple, though. Every time I tap my foot, I can see the audio wave, like, kind of go up a little bit, like it knows I'm tapping my foot, which I find very weird. How the hell can it hear it? means tapping without a shoe on carpet.
Look at all those additional voices.
You know, it was a good ending to this. I feel like it was a... Look at that, when I first got my chocobos. But I feel like, you know, it's not that it was a long, like, journey of a let's play, but it was the first one that I finally completed, and it was a great game. You know, I'll probably do my review right now. You know, the game was great. You know, the game was... I'm giving it an 8 out of 10. People will give it a 2 or whatever they may be, but I give it an 8 out of 10 just for the reason the story is good. Once you buy those season pass games, I mean these DLCs, I was about to say Diesels, but DLCs, you know, and you get the story, get to know the story a little bit more, and they add in these extra cutscenes and dialogue, and you get to know the story even more. You know, you understand that part of the story, so then... you don't have to complain about the story being not, you know, full and basically not understandable. But along with that, you usually get a good game. Now, the only flaw that it's not a 9 or a 10 out of 10 is for the reason that the game, you know, the difficulty factor, it's not that it has to be hard, but the normal factor of, you know, normal Final Fantasies is that you're able to do these strategies, you know exactly what to do, you know, prepare beforehand, rather than just you do this, you can just tap a button the whole entire game, use a whole bunch of potions. But aside from that, the game was great. You know, the combat was awesome. Hey, look, it's me. But no, the combat was awesome. And, you know, I had these issues here and there. The main issue, gripe about the controls that I had, was the fact that they binded the A button, you know, to jump and to pick up items. So I always normally jumped instead of picking up an item at the beginning, so it was irritating. But other than that, it was a very great game. The game was awesome. The story was awesome. You got to, you know, like the characters, and it was really cool in my opinion. Very great game. 8 out of 10, like I said. Send my top Final Fantasies. At least top 5. We're about to get another cutscene, though. This takes place, you know, you remember that campfire? The last one we did where we got the cup noodles? Well, here's the scene for it. This is where the fuel starts getting to you.
How long's it been?
An eternity.
So, yeah.
Out with it.
I just... Why the hell is this so hard? So I've made my peace. Still, knowing this is it, and seeing you here now, it's more than I can take.
Yeah, you're damn right it is.
Huh, you spit it out.
That's good to hear.
Well, what can I say? Do you guys are the best?
That last scene, it gets you, in my opinion. Like, it almost got me now, but I've watched the same scene multiple times of many people playing the game. You know, I've watched 3 different people play the game and beat the game, including me beating this game 3 times and now 4 times, so I've seen it. So it's not gonna get me like it did in the past. Like, when it first happened, when it first played, I'm not gonna lie, I shed some tears. And you might be like, nerd, shedding tears over a video game. You know what? It does not matter. You know, when you like a game and you're, you know, into a game, you can do that. You're allowed. In my opinion, it was just a great game. It was just great. There's nothing wrong with this game other than the fact that it was not finished at release. And they're still adding things to it even into 2019. I do not agree with that. That's another reason why I gave it a 8 out of 10 instead of a 10 out of 10. And even if they added the whole entire story, it still would have only got it a 9 out of 10. Just for the reason that I don't like the combat. I like the combat, but I don't like how easy the game is. I know that sounds weird. But also to that, I don't give things 10 out of 10s. There's not many games I give 10 out of 10s. I don't even know if I've ever given a game a 10 out of 10. Maybe as a kid, but I don't know if I've ever actually given one. But yeah, this game is really great. If you guys have never played it, I suggest playing through it. I suggest buying it. Buy the Royal Edition. That's probably out at this point when this video goes up. Buy it. Get that season pass. Put some time into it. Play through the whole game. If you bought this game and didn't like it, you know, and if you still have it, give it another try. You know, get past all the what people say about the game not being good. Get it past all that and just enjoy the game for what it is. A good time. Whether or not you don't understand the story and that irritates you, whether or not it's not finished, whatever it may be, just play through it and, you know, at least finish it. Because it's an honest, like, it's a really, really good game. Like, not even lying about that. Last scene. The light's finally being restored to the world. You know, being under darkness so long, Noctis finally fulfilled his duty as the chosen king and rid of the darkness among Eos, which is cool. It honestly is cool. And there's a specific speech in here that I might do a voiceover of just to, you know, practice a voice impression because it seems like a cool one. I believe that's Hammerhead in the distance, if I'm not mistaken, but I could be wrong. That's the... actually, I don't know. I was gonna say that's the crater. No, that was Discocothus, just very far in the distance. This is the fishing spot, the Vesper Pool, I believe. Yeah, there's a Discocothus right there. A lot of memories. This journey came to an end, though. That journey I don't want to be in, though. That chapter 13 was ridiculous, even though we didn't have to play, you know, the actual chapter 13. Maybe the other version. That part right there, when I first seen that part is the first part that actually broke me. Like, it broke me to a point where I was almost about to shed a tear, because I was already busy, like, going crazy, like, oh my god, it's sad. That part almost got me again, but then this upcoming part is the part that got me.
You did well.
to deliver the ring to Noctis. Wayward, though my son may indeed be, he has made me proud. May you too know happiness.
Remember the photo we picked? Yeah, this is what gets you, because if you picked a good photo, this gets you in the ending scene, and this finishes the job. If you weren't crying yet and you were invested in this game, this part made it happen. This part legit made it happen. All the YouTubers I watched had a tear. Three of them were men. My boy Noctis with the fresh shaved cut, man. Even though I like Noctis with the beard instead. But this is, you know, they finally are married. It's the dream, you know, what could have been, kind of. To a point you wish this was the actual, like, real life, but sadly it's not. The logo. Where my boy Noctis? Oh, wait. You want to pop up, Noctis? Hey, Noctis. Hey, yo, Noctis. There he is. Oh, my. What a great game. It doesn't matter what you feel about this game if you don't like it. I enjoyed it, and I hope you guys enjoyed the Let's Play. It was a very long Let's Play. And it was fun. It was honestly fun. I hope you guys had fun watching it. Even if you never played it, I hope you know, this made you at least want to play it a little bit. Made you want to enjoy it. But overall, like I said, the game is fun. Hey, I get a certificate, even though I've gotten plenty of these. We'll overwrite the next one, though. 93 hours. All right. Yeah, this was very fun. You see that date? Yeah, that ain't the date. That ain't the date from when this went up. But, man, it doesn't matter. Hopefully, you guys did enjoy this Let's Play. If you did, leave a like, subscribe, leave down in the comment section below a Let's Play you might want me to do in the future. And, as always, I will see you guys later.